Well, hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be doing small knotless braids and I'll be adding some colors to the side for the stitching or how I attach my hair. Once I have one of the sections ready, I'll go ahead and split it in three, just like you would when you're doing regular braids without extension. And after I split it in three, I am right-handed, so I place my left hand, or I would start out with a regular braid without extension. So once I do the placement of my left hand, I do not start stitching. I just place my left hand between the braids, and then I started adding the extension between my thumb and other finger right there. So and you choose the section of the hair according to the thickness you want, and then you start stitching. So I'll be showing you again, and once I do the stitching, I will either you keep adding hair depending on the client's hair, or depending on how thick the extension is. But you keep braiding all the way down until you get the right size braid. Yeah, so I will do it again for the next one. And at the top, I will also show you, you probably have a better view at the top. When you're doing these stitching, once you do the first set of adding the first set of extension, most likely you will start putting another piece for length, for extended length, at the end of the client's hair. So once you do all that stitching, the first set of adding the extension, once you reach to the end of the client's hair, because you will see. So here the way I'm placing my fingers, it's kind of awkward for me. I have to place it over my hand and then use the other piece to loop it around. This is how I'm doing it right now, but you'll see what I'm when I'm doing the other side. But yeah, normally you add the extension right are close to the end of the client's hair, because it's gonna show less density towards the end. So you kind of have to even out the braid, or even out the braid, make it look smooth, transition look smooth. So you don't want to have towards the top it's thick and at the bottom it's super thin. So you just have to kind of add a little piece more extension once you get to the end of the client's hair, so it smoothly braids out. So keep watching. So here you see I placed the hair over my hand. Keep placing it over my hand while adding the extension. It gives better grip for me. The hair is more tight, not tight, taut and sturdy. Once I add it, that's how it feels to me. So yeah. That's one way I feel more comfortable adding the hair. So instead of placing it, the first placement of the extension between my thumb and finger, I just place it over my hand, because I will have one piece between my finger and one piece over my hand. So here I'm doing the three parting, and I'll show you once again how I started attaching the extension. So So I'm going to place my left hand like that, and then I put the hair over, and then I started looping. So I place the hair over, then I started looping. It just gives a better grip for me, instead of trying to just grip it with my thumb and my finger. Just by itself, it just gives a bit, like it felt like it's loosening up my hold on the hair. So I just loop it over and grab that one end and start braiding. So yeah, keep watching. So here I'm doing another braid, and I will show you how I place my hand again to start the braid. I'm going to be placing my left hand just how I would start a regular braid. So I place my left hand and I put the hair over my hand and grab the one end, and then I stitch. Come back to my left hand, then I had another piece of extension, then I stitch, come back to my left hand, add another piece of extension. You're just gonna add it and to the liking, or to your liking, the thickness of the braid, and then you keep braiding down. And as I said, if you wanted to extend the length, that's where you would have added another piece of extension at the end of the client's hair, because you don't want to have, it's not supposed to be too thick, and towards the end it's super thin. You want to have a smooth transition. So yeah, I just keep adding that hair, I mean braiding that hair all the way down, and just keep watching to see how I do the rest of the hair. And guys, if you haven't subscribed, please go ahead and subscribe now so you can get more content like these and help my channel to grow. I have a lot in the making, but there has been some inconsistencies, but I'm working on it. Thank you. Keep watching. Remember to subscribe.